Right, I've just come across another poster which gives a bit of information about the war out here, very out in the wetlands. That barn isn't a barn at all. It's a hangar. It's a hangar, and apparently it's the only one left. There were more, so a hangar for hanging planes in, I suppose. I'm going to read up on it. Pawlett hams, the wet hams. All this was taken over by the military, and you see lots of stuff around this, and the barn there, which I call the barn. Okay, it's not, I was saying earlier, I wonder why it's so big. I've never seen such a big barn. I call it the mansion. Because it's not a barn, well, it might be used as a barn. It's actually the last remaining hangar of its type. Around here, there were more. So they must have been doing things with aircraft around here in the war. I said, this would all been a defence area because the Bristol Channel and the Parrot. Yeah, seriously, by diverting my walk, you actually come across stuff. That cloud's right up above me now and it's passing. So I'm glad I've done this now, because I thought, first of all, it's a private road, but it's actually leads to the wetlands, which is, looks like you are allowed to wander about, but seems to me that the cows will be out soon. And it's full of wildlife, all the little reens and ditches. Provide a rich habitat for plants, for birds, toads, newts, lizards. I'm going to read up on it. There's another stone coming up now. It seems to me they're like markers. Just imagine, I lived in Burnham for nearly 20 years. But of course, well, like I said before, when you're working, you don't get time to explore. So I'm glad I brought Energizer with me, because all around here was used but in World War II. I've seen some other weird looking structures back, which I've videoed or photographed on one of them. See, that indentation there is probably done for a reason. There's another marker board now. I'll just go and read off this one before I take photos. Wetland habitat, Pawlett Hams wetland site. The draining of Pawlett Hams, the land that you are currently standing on and the surrounding flatland can be inundated at high tide, making it difficult to farm. It is believed that the Romans were the first to try to control the water levels, although records only date from the 13th century. Reclamation of the riverbanks and the meadows next to them started in the late 1500s. In the 1630s, it is believed that as much as 277 acres were reclaimed on the Pawlett Hams. The hams can only be drained efficiently and water levels controlled due to a large tidal range of the River Parrot. At low tide, fresh water flows out of the site, and at high tide, the seawater cannot enter due to sluice gates. The flow of water is managed by the internal drainage board using three gates that open onto the River Parrot. The hams were extremely highly valued for grazing. In the early 17th century, entry payments for leases of pasture were £8 and 21 an acre, roughly the equivalent of £2,000 and £5,000 in modern money. Currently in 2010, entry payments are no longer a requirement and land can be leased for approximately £80 to £120 an acre. Well, that's not a lot, is it? Right, just turn that off a minute.